You asked me if an ordinary person, by studying hard, would get to be able to imagine these things like I imagine. Of course, I was an ordinary person who studied hard.
Everyone wanted to know the secrets behind how Richard Feynman, the Nobel Prize-winning quantum physicist, was able to move in the right direction, find all the information he needed in order to make big discoveries about the mysteries of life. We might think he's just a genius, but actually Feynman says this is his secret. You have to keep a dozen of your favorite problems constantly present in your mind, although by and large, they will lay in a dormant state. Every time you hear a new trick or a new result, test it against each of your 12 problems to see whether it helps. Every once in a while, there will be a hit and people will say, "How did he do it? He must be a genius." We have to keep a dozen of our favorite problems, and that's the difference. On my channel, I love talking about connecting ideas, but this really brings it home that it's not just about learning everything there is out there in order to make connections. It's about really finding things and see if they have a connection to the things that we're deeply curious about. All we need are some guiding posts, 12 guiding posts to be specific. So the second I heard this, of course, I took out a piece of paper and a pen and jotted down some of the questions I kept on asking about life. What are some of the questions I always come back to? And this is what I found. Number one, what is the role of a specialized generalist, a third culture adult, a professional turned creative in this world? Number two, how can I tell what's noise and what's signal? Number three, what's the real question? Number four, what's more important, serendipity or intention? Number five, what's more important, perception or truth? Number six, how do we develop our taste in music, food, people? Number seven, who are my people? Number eight, why do I feel a deep sense of calm and sadness when I watch wildlife and space documentaries? Number nine, how can I hold two opposing ideas at the same time and function? Number 10, how to shape an idea so it's ready to be received? Number 11, how can I stop my hangry self from getting grumpy? And number 12, when should I push forward and when should I pull back? That's step one, writing down your 12 problems. So take a minute and pause this video, do this now. Ask yourself, what are the questions I come back to? Because I realize there's also a step two after this. Step two, this is actually where it gets interesting. The 12 problems came out, but now it's time to look for similarities. Because I realized if these 12 problems are the symptoms, then actually the similarities are the cause, right? These 12 problems wouldn't leave me alone, and there's a reason for that. If you look at my problems, the similarity is quite obvious. I'm interested in a lot of duality management. I'm interested in polarity. How do I bring different things together? That's my thing. That's why I write about intersectional thinking. It's all about connection. That's why I care about input and output. How do I bring one to the other? That's why I care about communication. How can I share an idea that someone else might not be open to, and vice versa? And it all boils down to my identity, which I mentioned in my question one, actually. How can I be a specialized generalist? Does that make sense? To me, it does. How can I be a third culture adult? You know, am I Chinese, Canadian, Japanese, French? I don't know. It all comes down to being multiple things at the same time, and that really is who I am. And if you ever had trouble coming up, you know, your unique perspective, your unique point of view, these 12 questions will help you get to why you are unique, what's different about you. Because the things you're curious about come from your experience in life. If you don't believe it, just compare your questions with mine. And share your 12 questions in the comments so other people can also see what are the interesting things that you are curious about and how they see it as well. And then there's step three, which is what Feynman said. Now, every time you learn something new, put it against your 12 questions and see if there are connections there. Because chances are you picked up on something new, it's because you're curious about it. It's connected to your 12 questions in some sort of way. And watch those ideas grow with you as time accumulates, right? Use some sort of note-taking system. On this channel, I talk about Obsidian together with Zettelkasten, but you can use anything you like, just Apple Notes or pen and paper, it doesn't matter. Just track it over time and see the magic that will come from these 12 questions. Please let your 12 questions change your life. And check out this video here to set up your atomic notes, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!